Hello everyone, today we will discuss about vector differentiation. In the vector differentiation, first definition is scalar point function. Before going to scalar point function, definition for this scalar is scalar has only magnitude, and definition for the vector is vector has magnitude and direction. These are the standard definitions of scalar and vector. Now going to the scalar point function. So consider a region in three-dimensional space. To each point p of x, y, z, suppose we associate a unique real number, say phi. This phi of x, y, z is called scalar point function. If you consider a three-dimensional space, in that space each point p of x, y, z is associated with a scalar phi of x, y, z, then phi of x, y, z is called scalar point function. Next one, vector point function. To each point p of x, y, z, means this p of x, y, z is taken the three-dimensional space only. It is associated with unique vector f bar of x, comma y, comma z. Then f bar is called vector point function. Means p of x, y, z is a point, each point of three-dimensional space, then that point is associated with a vector f bar of x, y, z, then f bar of x, y, z is called vector point function. So next definition is vector differential operator. The vector differential operator del, this is called del, is defined as del is equal to I bar dou by dou x plus j bar dou by dou y plus k bar dou by dou z. We will define gradient, divergence and curl involving this operator. By using this operator, we find gradient, divergence and curl. So, first one is gradient. Gradient of a scalar point function. So, let phi of x, y, z be a scalar point function of position defined in some region of space. First, we have to take phi of x, y, z, that is a scalar point function that is considered in region of space. Then the vector function I bar dou phi by dou x plus j bar dou phi by dou y plus k bar dou phi by dou z is known as the gradient of phi and is denoted by grad phi or del phi. Here we observe one point. Phi is a scalar point function. Del phi is a vector function. So by using scalar point function and del operator, we find the gradient. So that is gradient of phi is vector function, and the formula for the gradient of phi or del phi equal to I bar dou phi by dou x plus j bar dou phi by dou y plus k bar dou phi by dou z. So by using the gradient, we find the directional derivative of the given surface. That is, the directional derivative of a scalar point function phi at a point p of x, y, z in the direction of a unit vector e bar is equal to e bar dot grad phi, that is e bar dot del phi. You can find the directional derivative to the given surface in the direction of any unit vector, that is e bar, then the directional derivative equal to e bar dot del phi. So how to find the e bar unit vector to the given surface, that is our given surface we can find the unit vector, and you can find the unit vector to the given vector also. How to find it? Where e bar is a unit vector in the direction of vector, in the direction of vector xi bar plus yj bar plus zk bar is then e bar equal to xi bar plus yj bar plus zk bar by length of the vector, that is under root of x square plus y square plus z square. So we'll discuss the note based on the gradient, that is del phi at any point is a vector normal to the level surface phi of x, y, z is equal to c through that point where c is a constant. Any surface in the form of phi of x, y, z is equal to c, then del phi is a unit a unit vector normal, or simply we can called as vector normal to that surface. So if any surface is given and find a vector normal to that surface, if you find simply grad phi or del phi, that is called vector normal to the surface. So next note is greatest value of directional derivative. If you want to find the greatest value of directional derivative or maximum value of the directional derivative of phi at a point P, that is equal to determinant of grad phi, or length of the grad phi, we can read as length of the grad phi or determinant of grad phi at that point P. Simply you can find the determinant of that grad phi, det of that grad phi or length of that grad phi, then that is called as greatest value of directional derivative. Then first example is find del of x square plus y square z. So let this function is f of x, y, z, or you can take phi of x, y, z also. So let f of x, y, z is equal to given function x square plus y square plus z square. You can find del of, means that you can find the gradient of f. That is, first you need to find the gradient, you need the partial derivatives of the given function. So that's why first find dou f by dou x, that is equal to 2x, because of x square derivative is 2x and y square z derivative is 0. Here y and z are constants. Next, dou f by dou y means differentiate with respect to y, x, z constants. So x square derivative is 0 plus z is constant. So z into y square derivative is 2y. So that is 2yz. Next, dou f by dou z, x square derivative is 0 with respect to z derivative, y square is constant, z derivative is 1, so that's why it is y square. So formula for del f, gradient of f is equal to I bar dou f by dou x plus j bar dou f by dou y plus k bar dou f by dou z. So del of, what is f? X square plus y square z, so that is del of x square plus y square z is equal to I bar, substitute dou f by dou x, that is 2x, plus j bar dou f by dou y is 2yz, plus k bar dou f by dou z is y square. Then we get a vector 2x I bar plus 2yz j bar plus y square k bar. This is our required del of x square plus y square z value. Next one, find the directional derivative of f is equal to xy plus yz plus zx in the direction of vector I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar at the point 1, 2, 0. So the given surface is f. You can find the directional derivative in the direction of the vector I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar. So you can find the E bar from I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar and find the del f at 1, 2, 0. So the formula for the directional derivative is E bar dot del phi or del f. Given function is f, so that's why del f. So that's why first you have to find the del f, and after that you can find the E bar. Multiply both, we get a directional derivative of the given function. So that first given f is equal to xy plus yz plus zx. So grad f, that is del f, is equal to I bar dou f by dou x plus j bar dou f by dou y plus k bar dou f by dou z. So I bar dou f by dou x with respect to x derivative. So here x derivative is 1 into y, yz derivative is 0, so plus 0 plus zx, x derivative is 1, that is plus z. So here y plus z, so dou f by dou x is equal to y plus z plus j bar dou f by dou y. So with respect to y derivative is 1 into x, and here also y derivative is 1 into z. So here x plus z, zx derivative is 0. So that's why we can multiply with x plus z plus k bar dou f by dou z with respect to z, xy derivative is 0 plus z derivative is 1 into y plus, here also z derivative is 1 into x, so that is y plus x. So now del f we find by using the formula. After that, if e bar is the unit vector in the direction of the vector I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar, then e bar is equal to, what is the formula for e bar? Xi bar plus yj bar plus zk bar by under root of x square plus y square plus z square. Here x value is 1, y value 2 and z value also 2 by using given vector, that is I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar by under root of this vector is 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square, that is 9. So root 9 means 1 by 3 of I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar. Therefore, the directional derivative of f equal to e bar dot del f. Then substitute the values 1 by 3 into I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar into y plus z into I bar plus z plus x into j bar plus x plus y into k bar. Here we can multiply these two by using the same pattern. I bar dot I bar is equal to 1, j bar dot j bar is equal to 1 and k bar dot k bar is equal to 1, and all of you know that I bar dot j bar is 0, I bar dot k bar is 0. So that's why we can multiply the coefficients of I bar, that is 1 into y plus z, 2 into z plus x plus 2 into z plus x plus 2 into x plus y, that is 2 into x plus y. Now we need to find the directional derivative at a point. So that's why the directional derivative of f at 1, 2, 0 is, means x value 1, y value 2, z value 0. Substitute in this directional derivative. So that's why here y value 2 plus 0, here z value 0, x value 1, 0 plus 1. Next, x value 1, y value 2. Then we can get 2 plus 2 plus 6 into 1 by 3. Then the value is 10 by 3. Here I write the values I bar dot I bar is 1, I bar dot j bar is 0, I bar dot k bar is 0, and j bar is 1, j bar dot k bar and j bar dot I bar also 0, and k bar is 1. So by using that we can multiply the values. Here we are substituting the x, y, z values in the gradient of phi also. After that finally we can multiply the constant vectors. Okay. So in the next example we can do it directly. So find the directional derivative of f of x, y, z is equal to x, y square plus y, z cube at the point 2, -1, 1 in the direction of the vector I bar plus 2j bar plus 2k bar. So here you can find the gradient to the f and find the unit normal vector to the given vector e bar and multiply both, we get a directional derivative at the point 2, -1, 1. So means that for the given function you can find a gradient and for the given vector you can find a unit normal vector. So first you have to take f xy square plus yz cube, then find the three partial derivatives with respect to x, y and z, that is dou f by dou x with respect to x, x derivative is 1 into y square, so y square, y z cube is constant, derivative 0. Next, dou f by dou y, here x is constant, y square derivative is 2y, so 2xy plus y derivative is 1 into z cube, that is plus z cube. Next, dou f by dou z with respect to z, x y square derivative is 0 plus y is constant, z cube derivative is 3z square, that is 3yz square. First you have to find the three partial derivatives. After that find the del f, that is gradient of f, equal to I bar dou f by dou x plus j bar dou f by dou y plus k bar dou f by dou z is a formula. Now substitute the values. I bar dou f by dou x value is y square plus j bar dou f by dou y value is 2xy plus z cube plus k bar dou f by dou z value is 3yz square. So xyz terms are in the del f only. E bar is a constant vector, so that's why you can substitute the point in del f. Finally you can multiply e bar and del f, so that's why now you can substitute the point in del f, that is I bar. Here x value 2, y value minus 1 and z value is 1. So I bar y square, so minus 1 whole square, plus j bar 2xy, 2 into minus 1, plus z cube 1 cube, plus k bar 3 into minus 1 into 1 square. So that is, here we get minus 1 whole square plus 1 I bar plus j bar into minus 4 plus 1, so minus 3, minus 3 j bar plus, here it is minus 3, 3 into minus 1 into 1, so minus 3 k bar. We get a constant vector to the del f at 2 comma minus 1 comma 1. So now going to unit vector in the direction of the given vector, I bar plus 2 j bar plus 2 k bar is e bar is equal to given vector by length of the vector, that is I bar plus 2 j bar plus 2 k bar by under root of 1 square. I bar coefficient is 1, j bar coefficient is 2 and k bar coefficient is also 2, so 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square, that is under root of 9, that is 1 by 3 into I bar plus 2 j bar plus 2 k bar. Then we can get the directional derivative by using the formula del f bar dot e bar. So then multiply del f, so we get a directional derivative at the given point 2 comma minus 1 comma 1, because of in the del f we substituted already point, so that's why we can get the directional derivative along the given direction of the point, or at the point 2 comma minus 1 comma 1 is del f bar dot e bar, that is I bar minus j bar minus 3 k bar into e bar is 1 by 3 I bar plus 2 j bar plus 2 k bar. Now you can write 1 by 3 into I bar coefficient is 1, here also 1, 1 into 1, 1 minus 3 into 2, so minus 6, minus 3 into 2, minus 6, so we get minus 11 by 3 is our required directional derivative. That's all for today.